Hey guys, my name's Sam and welcome to Prep Medic. In this week's video, we're discussing a couple tips and tricks to help you prepare for EMT or paramedic school. So you are looking at starting a career in EMS, or maybe you're looking at taking the next step and becoming a paramedic. One of the questions I get all the time in my DMs on Instagram is, hey, I've enrolled in this course and I want to know what I can do now to prepare for it. So before I get into my actual tips and tricks, I need to get it out there. There is no actual magic pill that's going to make EMT or paramedic school easy for you. There is nothing that is going to take the stress of those courses away or guarantee you're going to pass the whole thing, giving you this huge leg up on all your classmates. The reality is you have to put in the work in class for really anything to happen. You know, you have to make sure you're reading the book. I always recommend reading the chapter before the lecture the next day. You need to make sure you're asking questions, showing up to your clinicals on time. Really putting in that effort is going to be what's going to get you through these courses. That being said, I do think there are some things you can do if you have an extended period before you're going to get into the school, or maybe you're on a wait list or you're just trying to figure out something to fill the time. I do think there are some things you can do to make those courses a little bit easier. So the first recommendation I have for you is going to be take an anatomy and physiology class before you enter. Now, some paramedic schools will require you get your anatomy and physiology before you go into that, but even as an EMT, that course is going to help you understand a little bit more of the why behind the what instead of just see this, do this, which is really what EMT school is oriented towards. So if you can get that AMP in at a community college or even a university, if you don't even want a grade for it, you can audit these courses most of the time, still get the knowledge, do the work, just without the enrollment fee, if you're getting the full 3 credits or whatever it is. So that's kind of my biggest piece of advice. That course will not hurt you in any way, shape, or form, even if you decide to go in a different route. It just sets you up to understand more about the human body. So the next piece of advice I have for you is go to the National Registry's website and print out the skill stations that you're going to be taking at the end of your course. So if you're enrolling in an EMT course, go to National Registry's website, go to the EMT practical section, and listed right there will be the answers to the test that you will be taking at the end of the course. So this isn't your written test, this is your practical test where you have to walk into a room, you've got a patient, you've got a helper, and you've got a couple people that are grading you. And you have to go in there and you have to do a medical assessment, a trauma assessment, you have to put somebody on O2 at some point in time, and you have to do some kind of immobilization. There are some other stations that you'll take as a paramedic, but the point here is that these are literally the answers to the test. So if you can take those out, especially the assessment sheets, and memorize them, you're going to be so far ahead when you get to the end of the course. Now, will this help you be a better EMT or paramedic? I actually think it will, because when I get really stressed out, I fall back on those National Registry sheets. So if you can get that ahead of time and you can make some sense of it and you can just memorize line by line and read it off to somebody else through your head, you're going to pass your practical no problem. Now, the one thing I will stress for people going into paramedic school is paramedic school does not reteach you how to be an EMT. So they expect that you know these algorithms going into it. They're not going to reteach you them. So I would highly recommend you brush up on these and then look at some of the additional paramedic skill sheets. There are a couple ones that won't be covered that'll be a little bit harder to memorize, but the answers are still there for you. So the next one is not quite as applicable to people going into paramedic school, because in theory you have experience as an EMT, and that's far and above what I'm recommending here. But if you are in high school and you're looking for something to do until you can take your EMT course or until it starts, I would recommend getting experience as either a lifeguard or a ski patroller. Your outdoor emergency care course that you go through for ski patrol is very similar to an EMT basic course, and it will prepare you very well going into that field. As a lifeguard, this just gives you some of the initial terminology, some of the initial thought process, basic first aid, spinal immobilization, things that you're going to have to learn, and it's just going to help you acclimate into the medical field a little bit better. Now, last but not least, and this is the one I'm probably the most skeptical about as advice because it's not something that I would have ever considered doing, but I do think it has some efficacy in this realm, is take a medical terminology course. Once again, you can probably audit this course if you don't need the college credit for it, but there are a lot of different community colleges and universities that offer this. And what this allows you to do is take the words that you hear and you can actually apply meaning to them. So when somebody says something that starts with heme, for example, you know that has to do with blood. And that really starts helping you break down what a disease process is or what it is something means. It's not really that necessary, but it will help you kind of take that one extra step, bridge that gap when you go into the course. So if you've got a lot of time on your hands, you want to take two college courses, take the anatomy physiology, take the medical terminology course, and I think that will set you up well going forward. So going back to kind of the beginning of this video, I can't stress enough, there is nothing that is going to take these courses and make them easy. There's nothing that's going to let you float through it without having to exert effort. The reality is you have to read your textbook, you have to listen in class, and you have to be ready to put in a little bit of additional work outside of class to really be successful. Now, the last point I want to make is that passing this course with a minimum score is not your goal or should not be your goal. You are going to go out into the field after you pass your EMT or paramedic course, and you're going to be expected to take care of patients in life-threatening conditions. So if all you're worried about is passing a test with whatever the minimum is, whether that's 70%, 80%, whatever your course has set, that's not good enough. All of the things listed here will help you be a better provider in the long run. They're not just here to help you pass the class. That's all I have for this video. If you guys have any questions or if you have any ideas, please leave them in the comments down below, and I will see you next week.